Have you ever seen any Android application and you go like, damn, that's a really good one? Well, KDE Connect belongs to that category of open source applications that can let you do multiple things. Let's say you want to share files between two Android devices or between a phone and a PC. This application can do it in the blink of an eye. If you want to use your phone as a touchpad, you can do that as well. And I really like this gyroscope feature where you can move the PC cursor through phone movement. But that's not all. If you want to receive your phone notifications on a PC or control multimedia, this application is capable of doing all this. And everything is end-to-end encrypted. KDE Connect is available for Android, Windows, macOS, and Linux, and is completely free to download. If you have ever used FFmpeg on your PC, you know how handy it is. If you want to convert any file from one format to another, you can do it very easily by using some simple commands. Well, we have a similar feature for Android now, but in the form of an application called FFShare that can help you compress or convert image, video, and audio files very quickly. But you don't need any commands here. There are two different ways to use this application. You can open your gallery or file manager and share the file through FFShare. It will automatically compress or convert the file. The other way is to open FFShare and select the file you want to convert or compress, and this application will do the rest. If you want to go with the default options, that's perfectly fine. But you can change the conversion format, CRF rate, image queue scale, and compression preset in the application settings to get a better or lower quality output. The third application that we have here is a very handy tool to manage PDF documents. Normally what happens with most of us is that if we download any important PDF document on our phone, we completely forget about it, or it just stays in some folder. And that's where GreenPass PDF wallet comes to help. This application is nothing else but a simple wallet to store your important PDF documents so that you can access them easily. It's completely open source and offers some excellent features like PDF sharing, opening and printing, and is very easy to use. You can simply import the PDF document from your phone storage or open your file manager, email, web browser or any PDF reader application and share the file through GreenPass. It will automatically save the file. You can also log this application, sort or rename your PDF documents and enable dark mode as well. At number 4, we have a small but a very handy application called SafeSpace. If you want to protect any file on your phone, this application will create a separate space that is going to stay encrypted and won't be visible to any other application. The interface is very simple and there is nothing flashy here. You can create folders if you want to organize your files or simply upload any file directly. If you want to delete or export any file, you can simply tap on this thumbnail and you will get the menu. Deleting the file inside SafeSpace does not delete the original file, or deleting the original file does not delete it from SafeSpace. So basically it will create two different files and you can delete the original one from your phone. I hope you guys understood this. Now the last application in today's video is related to Android customization, and who does not love customizing an Android phone? Apart from icon packs and widgets, having a wallpaper application is really important, and if you get that for free, that's amazing, right? WallFlow is an excellent and a new application that gives you a huge collection of wallpapers. Right now, the only source is Wallheaven, but you can expect more to be added soon. If you want to know what is special about this application, let me show you some super cool features. There is a multi-pane layout, so wide screens are supported. If you own any Android tablet, then this is going to be amazing. There's an auto wallpaper changer. How to enable it? Go to settings, enable auto wallpaper. Go back to homepage, search for any category here. I'll select 4K. Tap on it, select save as, and name it as per your preference. Now if you go to settings, you'll get an option to use the collection. Simple and easy. You can set the wallpapers directly or download them on your phone, or even share them as links or images. There's also an advanced filter section where you can choose categories or sort the wallpapers and even choose the resolution or ratio. And that was the video, guys. Let me know your favorite application from today's list. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a comment and subscribe to the channel as well. That would be great. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.